Imagine you have landed and there is an issue with the aircraft. After shutting down the engines, you write the defect in the aircraft technical logbook and call for maintenance. If the engineer can fix the issue right away, the aircraft will be released for service. Sometimes a reset is all you need. After all, ATR means always try reset. However, if the issue cannot be resolved, for example there are no spare parts, the engineer will open a minimum equipment list, MEL, and check whether the aircraft can be released for service with this defect. If not, the aircraft will remain grounded until it is repaired. Hello aviators, how are you today? My name is Magnar Nordahl, I'm an ATR captain and instructor. Modern airliners are intricate machines with systems designed to work in harmony. To ensure critical systems remain operational after a failure, the aircraft have one or two additional units as backup. For example, we have three airspeed indicators, three altimeters, and we have two hydraulic systems, each powered by a dedicated pump. Both systems can be supplied by a single pump through a crosswind. This means that even if one pump has failed, the systems reliant on hydraulic power remain fully functional. However, in such cases, the redundancy of the hydraulic system is reduced. And this is where the minimum equipment list comes into play. The purpose of the MEL is to improve aircraft utilization while maintaining an acceptable level of safety. The aircraft manufacturer provides a manual called a Master Minimum Equipment List, Master MEL. This document specifies which systems that may be inoperative for dispatch and the conditions for doing so. Since the Master MEL covers all variants of the aircraft type, the operators are required to create a MEL customized for their specific aircraft, its equipment, and operational needs. Operators may choose to make the MEL stricter than a Master MEL, but they are not permitted to make it less restrictive. And of course, the MEL does not include the obvious items such as wings, rudder, engines, landing gear, and items which do not affect the airworthiness of the aircraft, such as galley, catering, entertainment systems, blankets, and pillows. In this video, I used the Master MEL for ATR-72-600. Other manufacturers might use a different format, but the principle is always the same. This MEL is divided into four sections. Preamble, alert message list. This is only for the 600 variant because it shows all alerts from the alert window. Then we have operational part and maintenance part. This is the operational part for ATA 24 electrical power. Item number 242101 is AC inverter. This is the revision date. All means it is valid for all aircraft. In a company's MEL, you will find the serial number or registration for each aircraft. RI means rectification interval. A means the item shall be rectified in accordance with the remarks stated in the text below. In this case, operations are limited to not more than 2 calendar days, starting at 0001 on the calendar day following the day of discovery. The limitation can also be a certain number of flights or flight hours. B means within 3 consecutive calendar days, excluding the day of discovery. For example, if it was recorded at 10 a.m. on January 26th, the 3-day interval begins at midnight and ends at midnight on January 29th. C means 10 days and D 120 days. A dash redirects you to another reference item which provides the rectification interval category. In this case, you are redirected to item 243202, DC generation bus type contactor, BTC. NI means number installed, and R means number required for dispatch. The conditions for dispatch are listed below. Placard, it's yes or no. When required, there will be an in-op sticker placed next to the control or indication. If an operational procedure is required, there will be a reference in the text below. If a maintenance procedure is required, it is found in the maintenance part, MMP. And here is one important thing to remember. A system can fail, a system indication can fail, and a system alert can fail. So it's very important to identify the correct item when you read the MEL. If inverter number one has failed, the alert message list says no dispatch. If inverter number two has failed, you follow operational procedure 242101. The rectification interval is A, and the text says operations are limited to not more than 2 calendar days. 2 are installed, and 1 is required for dispatch. And you need a placard. No operational or maintenance procedures are required. The text states number 2 can be inoperative provided that A. The flight is conducted in day VMC only, that is visual meteorological conditions, and B. Autopilot is prohibited below 1000 feet above ground level, and C. Operations are limited to not more than 2 calendar days, and D. TLU manual mode is operative. The TLU is the rudder travel limit unit, which restricts the movement of the rudder at high speeds. It's usually automatic. And now we have to check that the manual mode is operative. That is the system. If the inverter fault light has failed, you follow item 242102. There is no alert for this. The only way to identify an indication failure is to check the annunciator lights. And this is done before the first flight of the day. In this case, there is an operational procedure which must be performed before every departure. Another rule, if a system has failed and it has an on-off switch, you leave it off. After all, that is what the checklist told you to do. Let's say the green hydraulic pump has failed. The indication is low pressure, and the checklist tells you to select the affected pump off. After landing, you make an entry in the aircraft maintenance logbook and call maintenance. If the item cannot be rectified, the engineer will perform the maintenance procedure. Attach an in-op sticker next to the push button for the pump and defer the item in the aircraft maintenance logbook with reference to MEL. The pilots will check MEL and read the limitations. The MEL doesn't tell you to keep the affected pump off, but since it doesn't work, there is no reason to select it on, is it? That was the hydraulic pump. Item 2931.01 is the low-level light. The purpose of this light is to alert you if there is a leak in the associated system. Without it, the hydraulic level must be checked prior to each departure, and hydraulic crosswind must not be used. The operating procedure is to monitor hydraulic pressure during flight. If the low pressure light has failed, then you follow item 2932.0101. Here the pressure indication must be operative. If you have lost the pressure indication, the low pressure alert must be operative. And if you have lost overheat alert, you refer to item 2933.01. In this case, you must consider the associated pump to be inoperative, and it must not be used. The operational procedure is to select the pump off. Finally, a few words about decision making. This video is from a flight from Lagos towards Akure in Nigeria. Shortly after we leveled off, DC bus number 2 failed. The autopilot is connected, so I continued manually. That's why you see those little dips on the wings. The destination, Akure, is a small airport, so the decision was very easy, return to base. The weather was good, and after completing the checklists and preparing for approach, we even had time to enjoy the scenery. When a system fails in flight, you may face many options. I have listed them in order of priority. Number 1, safety. Number 2, if the checklist tells you to land ASAP, as soon as possible, you land at the nearest suitable airport. 3. Land at an airport where the aircraft can be repaired. Maybe there is a replacement aircraft there as well. Number 4. Land at an airport with an engineer who can release the aircraft, if MEL allows. It can be a good idea to check in MEL whether aircraft can be released with this defect or not. And the last option is land at a suitable airport and check in at a hotel. Some companies allow the captain to sign off the aircraft with reference to MEL. That's a good thing, but it only works when there is no maintenance procedure required. In my case, we had a bus failure and the aircraft was grounded after landing. The culprit was a contactor. Well, that is all for this time. Thank you for watching, and a special thank to the members of the channel. They can enjoy my videos without advertisements for 2 days before it's published. Thank you for watching, have a wonderful day, and happy learning!